Rescuers race against time in search for more survivors after a magnitude 5.6 quake rocked Indonesia's Java Island Monday. 162 people are confirmed dead and around two dozen remain missing. Hundreds of others are wounded. The tremor, which was felt all the way in the capital, Jakarta, has triggered over 60 aftershocks. Authorities warn residents to stay on alert for rain, which could set off landslides. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says so far, no Filipino was hurt or reported hurt in that quake. Another quake strikes off the coast of Solomon Islands in the South Pacific. Initial reports say the magnitude 7 tremor knocked out power in parts of the capital, Honiara. There are no immediate reports of casualties. Authorities warn of hazardous waves along coast located within 300 kilometers of the quake's epicenter, but there is no tsunami threat for Hawaii as well as the Philippines. U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris set to visit Palawan, the province closest to the Philippines' tug-of-war with China in the West Philippine Sea, this afternoon. This as Harris affirmed America's commitment to help defend the Philippines from any attack when she met Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Monday. Pia Gutierrez reports.
The United States and the Philippines reaffirming long-standing ties amid upheavals in the Asia-Pacific region during the visit of U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris in the country Monday. Harris, the highest-ranking U.S. official to visit the country during the present administration, arrived past noon in Malacanang for a meeting with President Marcos Jr. The chief executive says Harris's presence in the country is proof of the strength of the relations of both countries.
The situation is rapidly changing. We must evolve to be properly responsive to that situation. And so that is why it is very important that we continue to progress, that we continue to strengthen, and we redefine those relationships. So your visit is a very strong symbol that these relationships remain strong, mm-hmm. and that these relationships remain important, as indeed they do.
Meanwhile, the U.S. Vice President reiterated the United States' commitment to the Mutual Defense Treaty amid continuing tensions in the South China Sea. The 1951 agreement calls on both the United States and the Philippines to come to the aid of the other in case of attack.
I will say that we must reiterate always that we stand with you in defense of international rules and norms as it relates to the South China Sea, an armed attack on the Philippines' armed forces, public vessels, or aircraft in the South China Sea would invoke U.S. mutual defense commitments. And that is an unwavering commitment that we have to the Philippines.
Prior to Harris's visit, the White House announced new initiatives to further strengthen the alliance of the U.S. with the Philippines, particularly on climate change, food security, energy security, and digital economy.
The basis of our relationship is multifaceted. Our relationship is based on mutual commitment to the economic prosperity of the region and our respective nations. And during the conversation that we have today, we will talk more about what that means in terms of the opportunities that are presented through our mutual concern about the climate crisis and what we might do in terms of investments in renewable energy and thinking about clean power and the industries that will come about because of that commitment.
Before going to Malacanang, Harris met with her counterpart, Vice President Sara Duterte, at the Aguado House in Manila and discussed several issues including education, security, poverty, and employment. Both officials also had a chance to talk about their common love for food. After her meetings in Manila, Harris is set to fly to Palawan, the province closest to the West Philippine Sea. But while political analyst attorney Edward Chico sees her visit there as a strong show of support to the Philippines' position on the West Philippine Sea, he does not see it further fanning tensions with China on the area.
Ito ay pagpapakita lamang ng posturing, ano, na parang sinasabi ng Amerika na sa pagbisita sa Pilipinas, titintigan namin ang Pilipinas at anumang issue patungkol sa Sitgalot, halimbawa sa West Philippine Sea, ay makakaasa ang Bansang Pilipinas na ang Amerika ay titindig sa kanya.
President Marcos Jr. earlier downplayed concerns on Harris's visit in Palawan, saying that the province is well within Philippine territory. Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.